SEC. I'm amazed DeAndre Swift didn't go in the first round, Stanford Steve. And the guy at the bottom, if you care about what me and Stanford Steve think, Michael Pittman Jr., pick him up. I don't care what he ran. He's football fast. That guy can go. We welcome Mel Kiper Jr. to the show. And Mel, at the end of round one, it's best available, right? But I guess I'm framing this different. I want to know who's the guy who's still available that you cannot believe is still sitting out there.
I don't think there's one that I would say I'm shocked is still available. Okay. I will say the highest rated player, Scott, was Xavier McKinney, 15th on the board, a safety out of Alabama, only ran 4.63 at the combine. You know, safeties aren't prioritized like corners are. We saw that a lot of corners like A.J. Terrell forced way up there to Atlanta, much higher than I thought they should have been because they're corners. That's what this league's all about, cover men. The safeties always get pushed down, and that's what happens to a guy like Xavier McKinney. Now he goes second round. Nothing wrong with that. It's going to be a great value pick for somebody who's going to play right away and be an impact performer.
You and I have talked a bunch about the tackles, and you thought a bunch would go high. They did. What struck you about the order in which they were selected?
I thought it was interesting because they were all tied to a young quarterback. You think about Andrew Thomas. He's up there. Why did the Giants take him? Because he's a left tackle. He hasn't been a right tackle who's going to be forced to project the left tackle. So he was a natural left tackle. The end of his career, I played a little right tackle early on when he was working opposite Isaiah Wynn. But the last 2 years, he was the left tackle, and that's what they need to help out Daniel Jones and obviously Saquon Barkley. Cleveland got Jedrick Wills, who I think will be a left tackle. He's going to have to be with them because they got Conklin, Jack Conklin, to be the right tackle. Then Mekhi Becton with Sam Darnold and the Jets. Then you think about Tristan Wirfs. He's helping out Tom Brady and Austin Jackson with Tua. So all the tackles that went relatively early down to Jackson were all tied to either a young quarterback or Tom Brady. And then even Tannehill getting Isaiah Wilson for Tannehill. So I would think it was interesting. The GMs there went for the tackle to help the young quarterback for the most part. And like I said, and you knew Tom Brady. You're not drafting the heir apparent. You're drafting somebody to help him this year or next year.
All right, only 32 down. We got six more rounds to go, Mel. Appreciate the time. Get some rest, sir.
Thanks, Scott. Appreciate it, pal.
After the New England Patriots traded their first-round selection to the Chargers, that left seven teams yet to make a pick in this year's draft. Indianapolis Colts will be the first of those teams to select on Friday as they've got the second selection in the second round. New England will be next, taking the 37th overall pick initially held by LA. Enjoy the draft Friday, 7 Eastern, rounds 2 and 3. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.